Hi, this video is part of the Every Drop Count series, brought to you by Piedmont Environmental Alliance, a nonprofit in Winston-Salem that educates the public on ways to make a positive impact on the environment. Think of all the ways you've already used water today. Did you brush your teeth? Drink anything? Take a shower? Flush the toilet? We often use water in our daily lives without even noticing. Water is important for staying hydrated, staying clean, and staying healthy. It makes many of the comforts in life possible, but it's also necessary to survive. Water allows us to metabolize or use our food, get rid of our waste or go to the bathroom, and transport nutrients to our cells. We can't live without it, and neither can any other living organism on Earth. We all depend on water in some way to function. So we need water, but how much of it do we actually have? Look at our Earth from space. You can see why it's called the Blue Planet. Over 70% of Earth's surface is covered in water. That quantity of water never changes. In fact, there's the same amount of water on Earth now as there was in the age of dinosaurs. No new water is ever added, and none of our existing water is ever taken away. So the quantity of water stays the same. But it's not always found in the same form. Water can exist as a solid, liquid, or gas. This change occurs due to exposure to hot or cold temperatures. This is all part of the water cycle, and the way that water changes through processes like evaporation, condensation, and precipitation. All of the other water on Earth can be found in six different sources: permanent ice, like glaciers, groundwater, and other sources like surface water, including lakes, wetlands, and rivers, and water vapor in the atmosphere. The sixth source is the ocean, which is different because the water is salinated, also known as salt water. Fresh water, found in the first five sources, is water that we can safely drink, and it is vital to the survival of all living organisms on Earth. So, we've established that we have a ton of water on Earth, and all living things on Earth need fresh water to survive. But how much of this water is available and useful to us? Let's explore how much of Earth's water exists in each of these sources. First, ice. Ice is the largest source of fresh water on Earth. It includes glaciers, ice shelves, and ice sheets. Ice makes up about 69% of all the fresh water on Earth, and it's all frozen, which makes it unusable. Groundwater makes up 30% of Earth's fresh water. It also supplies the U.S. with up to 51% of its drinking water. This is water found underneath the Earth's surface in soil and rock formations. If you use a well at your home, you use groundwater. Now, since ice makes up 69% of the world's fresh water and groundwater 30%, that leaves 1% of the world's fresh water for the remaining freshwater sources: surface water like lakes, wetlands, and rivers, and water vapor in the atmosphere. Although each of these sources are immensely valuable to their unique ecosystems, they make up a very small fraction of the water on Earth. The ocean is the largest source of water on the planet, although it is all salt water. In fact, all of the fresh water combined, including ice and groundwater, only makes up 3% of all water on Earth. 97% of water on Earth is salt water, and therefore undrinkable. All of this means that only a very small percentage of the water on Earth is useful to us. And although we will never gain new water or lose the water we have, it can change forms. This poses a problem for our already limited fresh water. We'll learn more about this in our next video about climate change. Thank you to our sponsors for making this video possible.